Yeah, it feels loose. Yeah, I can feel it. It feels loose, like it's going to fly off. And there's been some wind earlier. But if the wind gets up again, that thing's going to, you know. Yeah, it feels loose. I can feel it. It feels kind of loose to me. Yeah, get that bottle. It says hairpiece adhesive on it. Not the super glue. I don't want this thing stuck in my head to the grave, for Christ's sake. Come on, Pam. Pay attention. Yeah, it says hairpiece adhesive, and it's got a, if you open it up, it's got a little brush inside. Yeah. If the wind's blowing, this thing flips back, it's going to look like my head is shitting a giant ostrich egg, for Christ's sake. I don't want that. Yeah, bring it here. What? Okay, well, why didn't you tell me the camera's going? Jesus. Let's edit this part out. Okay. Edit this part out, though. And take it off, okay? All right, thanks. We'll do that after the next one. We'll do the bees later. Whatever. Okay. 3, 2, 1. Hi, folks. How you doing? Woohoo! Kel here. We've got a package opening. This is that pipe I bid on. I don't know if I... Did I put that video up? I put that video up or not. Anyway, I made the video, but it's not here. The Lumberman Sir Jacopo from England. It's the one I did the video about buying it on eBay. And I've covered all the nasty bits up. If I don't cover those up like that, people see my actual dress on camera. You know, they'll be like a bunch of young girls waiting outside my door every day, you know, in various shades of undress. You know, they just want to have sex with me. You know, it's just a lot of bother. So I got to cover that up. Anyway, so I've been waiting. I got this thing early today, and it's like 10 o'clock at night or later now, and I just thought it'd be nice to open it up on camera so you can see for the first time. My scissors here. I just figured when I do this, the scissors are going to cut through the package. You know, cut through what's inside or something, you know, kind of a ruined object, but this is inside. I can feel it inside of a box. Ooh. A crushed box. Look at that. That's not good news. You know, people are going to send stuff from England, they should really, really pack it better. Anyway, thing is, this only took like five, six days. It's the 6th today as I make this video. And this was shipped on the 29th. So that's pretty amazing if you think about it. There's the tax thing on the back, the import tax. Yeah, I wish he'd, I always write these guys and tell them to please separate the pipe so it's not together when you ship it, and to please, you know, bubble wrap the hell out of it, because that's how pipes get ruined. And he didn't do that, it looks like. Oh, he did do that. Okay, good man. Good man. Here's the pipe in the package. He did exactly as I asked, because if you don't do that, pipes with the stem in, you know, get a little bit of flexing or whatever, it'll break the stem like crazy. The shank rather than the pipe. And so he did what I asked him to do. Good man. He's a good guy, by the way, over there. This is the one I got a heck of a deal on. I paid $89 for this. $89 plus shipping. Shipping was only $11, and for it to arrive here in just literally 5 days, 6 days, I think that's amazing. I thought it might be 2 or 3 weeks, especially since it has to go through customs. Open this baby up here. Oh, that looks nice. Looks like brand new. There's the shank of it right there. The shank. A little Italian Sciacquo J on there. Now this is a Maxima, which means it's what they consider their giant, one of their giant pipes. Well, holy plums. Take a look at this. And there's the shank itself. I'm gonna focus in on that for you there. If you can see that or not. This is much better looking than the picture would have ever shown to me. I'm right away off the bat very impressed. Now back to me, my beautiful countenance. You're better off actually having my film's blurry, I think, is the way I look these days. Let's put that in. Oh, it fits in very nicely, not too tight, not too loose. But this is a maximum. I mean, this is probably over 7 inches long, I think, or almost 7 inches long. Let me focus back the pipe again for fun. Get my camera to focus. That's pretty nice, I must say. I'm very impressed, you know. He said he'd smoke this thing one time with some Virginias in it or something. Looks like that could be the case. About half full. So cleanup on this is going to be very easy. It'll be very easy to clean this pipe up. It'll be very easy to clean this thing. I always do. I always like, you know, alcohol, clean the stem and everything. And I'll put alcohol down there on a pipe cleaner very carefully. one of those fluffy ones I showed in that one video. But yeah, it smells like Virginia's basically. No English, which is nice, because English, I would have to do probably a salt cleanup to get it back to where I could smoke it, you know, with something besides English. And the, can I focus this? I'm going to make sure I didn't, because it's cameras. But it looks nice, you know. I won't put my mouth yet, because I do want to clean up. Got a little bit of scuzz on there. Looks like, but it pretty much looks like new. $89, I mean, that's a heck of a deal. I'm not going to mention you guys, a lot of guys don't want to buy pipes in foreign lands. I got a really good deal on that Don Carlos, you know, that one that's in my pipe collection videos. I got like, I think it was $75 or $76 I paid for that pipe. That guy had two other pipes for sale. When I was trying to get that one, I ended up bidding on those two and getting those as well. I got a Siakpo with a filter. I ended up selling that because I'm kind of done with filters. But anyway, the point is that got a really stellar deal on that pipe. And I got that deal partially because it was being sold in Germany. This guy was a guy in Germany who was either selling off a collection or he was a dealer who bought a bunch of pipes or something, I don't know. And I no one was bidding on it, you know, that's why I got a good deal on it. And I think a similar thing happened with this pipe here. I think the people didn't really want to bid on it because it's in England. They're afraid they're not going to get their pipe, you know, they're a little bit, you know, nervous about that. And I'll mention you guys out there, that most people don't know this, by the way. But if you see a pipe in England, I bought a really nice pipe from Japan once, a Paul Wunzel, and I think a pretty good deal on it. That's a good thing that it's in a foreign country because people won't bid on it. There'll be fewer people bidding. You can get a better price. And the thing with it is, if you fear losing your money, don't, because eBay has a really good program now of refunding your money. Even if the person who sold the pipe disappeared and never got your pipe, eBay will refund your money. They will do that. I've had that happen. I bought a memory card from the Middle East at one point. I don't know, that was the first mistake. But I never got the memory card, you know. But eBay refunded my money in total and whole. It was like $25 or $30 or something. But still, they did. They refunded my money in whole, totally, and that was really a cool thing. I'm not going to clean this up on the camera, I don't think, because it doesn't require much cleaning. This will be very quick cleanup for me. It's not going to require much, and I think I want to smoke it tonight, and so I'm going to clean it up real quick, and off camera. I made the video of that other one, other auction pipe that I did clean up on camera, so this one I won't do that with. Maybe I won't smoke tonight. Maybe we'll smoke smoke. It's a beauty, isn't it? And that's huge. It's a big pipe. That's nice. You know? That's a nice size. And the grain on it is, the sandblast is nicer than I thought it was going to be. I thought the sandblast would be not so hot, but it's actually quite nice. I'm actually kind of enthused, but I don't know what the inside of the bowl looks like. It looks pretty good. I don't think I'll find any surprises, hopefully. But yeah, that's nice. Well, that's it, folks. That's the auction pipe that I got on auction. Like I said, I had to wait all day to open this thing. I really wanted to open it right away because I've really been anxious to get this pipe. I've really been anxious to get this thing. I really wanted it really quite badly. I wanted to open it up. I was really not enjoying waiting for it to arrive from England. I thought it would be 3 weeks or a month, actually. I've ordered things from overseas before, and it can take a month between customs here and everything else. But this was great. With the service he used, we're talking 6 days. That's quicker than it would be in the United States sometimes. So and I had to go through customs too. That's really quite amazing. So, well, there it is anyway. That's nice, isn't it? And I believe this is what they call a lumber bun because it's got a round shank on it. You know what I'm saying? Not a flat one. You know. But anyway, whatever. It's a big, good size. It's gonna be a good smoker, I bet. Looking forward to. Well, that's it, folks. Thanks for watching. And hope you're enjoying your pipes and you're collecting and enjoying your life. But that's a tip for you. If you see a pipe overseas, just as long as it's not Jacopo or Costello's, you don't want to bid on those overseas or even here in the States. Never bid on Jacopo pipes or Costello's, either in the States or overseas. Never. Unless you check with me first and see if it's what I don't want. It's what I don't want. Go ahead. All right. Well, thanks for watching. I'll talk to you later.